was having such a nice dream. At least I think it was a dream. Did I cop off of anyone last night?
Not that I'm aware of.
Oh, damn.
Fancy a cuppa?
Oh, I'd love one, please, Mum.
Are you going to be working all day?
Mum.
You should be out enjoying yourself.
Too much work to do. If I don't get these notes finished for Tuesday, David Cash will go mad.
He expects too much of you.
Well, maybe, but he is my boss. And whilst he's looking for an excuse to get rid of me, I'm going to prove to him that I'm committed and he'd be a fool to sack me.
Look, I understand you're very busy, but you will take some time off tonight to support your dad, won't you?
I'm not sure I can.
It's important, Holly. You know how he feels about your Nana. It's going to be difficult for him. He really wants things to work out this time with
her. I'll try, I promise.
Thanks. Now, boys, I don't want to see any dust in this room when you've finished. My mother's got eyes like a hawk.
How does this thing work, Mrs. Hart?
It's a vacuum cleaner, Roy, not a nuclear reactor. Plug it in.
Hello. No, I'm sorry, he's not home. Who is it? Well, Jennifer, can I take a message? Okay. I thought we'd given her the push. Maybe she can't take a hint.
Who's Jennifer?
Never you mind.
How come you two aren't going out with anyone?
I was. I'm in between girlfriends.
Ditched you, did she?
No.
Yes, she did.
Well, you'll never find anyone if you keep hanging around here all the time. Unless you fancy our Holly, but I suppose she'd be a bit too intellectual for you. You see, Tim, women don't want new men. They like them strong and mysterious.
Oh, and you're an expert, are you, Casanova?
You might be.
Yeah. Who was that on the phone?
Somebody the Duncans, the bros of bros.
Hey! Haven't you two got homes of your own to go to? We see more of you two than we do our own.
I've seen an awful lot of Roy recently, haven't I, love?
Yeah, well, wait a minute. What was all that about? And what time's Melanie supposed to be getting here?
Who are this lot? I don't recognise any of them. Haven't they got homes to go to?
I don't believe this.
What does this mean? If we don't pay today, he'll take appropriate action.
I don't know. Don't put anything past him.
Well, you can't do this.
It's our own fault. If everybody had bought their own booze, we wouldn't end up forking out. And maybe then we'd pay some rent.
All right, all right.
Well, we're skint. The phone's about to be cut off, the electricity bill's due, and there's the gas.
Claire, you are doing my head in. Something will turn up.
Like what?
I don't know. Oh, is that the time? I'm supposed to be at Mum and Dad's. They're going to kill me.
Yeah, and so will Roy if we don't get his disco equipment back to him. You'd never have taken it from your mum's.
We didn't take it. We borrowed it. Roy won't mind.
Yes, he will. The whole reason it was in the shed was so it'd be safe.
Look, we'll get it back. He'd be none the wiser. Oh, I do hope Dad's patched things up with Nana Sally. He'd be unbearable if he hasn't. Who's this? He can come again. Well, come on. Get dressed. You're invited as well.
Since when?
Oh, since you volunteered to pay the bus fare there.
You look nice.
I feel terrible.
Oh, yes.
It's my stomach.
Indigestion, probably. You'll live. Why don't you sit down, Cross?
I can't. Where's our Mel?
She'll be here.
Any sign of Duncan?
Not yet.
I took another call for him from some poor lass. The way he treats these women is terrible. What's wrong with him?
He's young, that's all. If he's playing around like this in 5 years' time, then we should worry. This isn't about Duncan, though, is it? Sit down, Chris. It's going to be all right.
I've been thinking about my mother all morning.
I know.
She said she'd never forgive me, and after what happened at Christmas, well, maybe she meant it.
It was a heat of the moment thing, love. I'm sure she regretted it as soon as she said it.
I hope you're right, Annie. I've got to make this work this time.
I must get changed.
They should have been here by now.
Well, why don't you ring Newcastle? Make sure they're on their way.
I can't. What if she picks up the phone and she's deciding not to come?
What have you got to lose?
You know I do. Of course. But whenever I get the chance. Yeah, I feel the same. Yeah, no, that's a good idea, Andrew. Yeah, right, I'll see you then. Bye.
Ready?
Just gotta get my jacket.
far much, is he?
Come on, Mel, baby! You've usually slaughtered him by now.
Not.
Roy, see this? You did not have this done, did you? Yes.
No way!
The winner again. Oh, right, hand it over.
You must be joking. I was winning. She used sex to put me off.
Oh, well, you shouldn't have looked then, should you, perv?
She's got a point. Cheap.
You haven't won at arm wrestling again, have you? How many times have I got to tell you, Roy? Never mess with us hearts.
She cheated.
Hi, Claire.
Hi.
Right, come on, you lot. Out of here. Your mum's about to make a start in the kitchen, so you better get out of her way. Unless you want to help her clean, of course.
There you are. Well, did you phone them?
Who?
Your mum and dad. Why not?
Oh, what do you mean mum answers the phone? What am I going to say?
Hello, ma'am.
Oh, you know what I mean. Oh, you get it.
Oh, for goodness sake, Chris, it's your mother at the door, not the Grim Reaper. You go.
Anyone home?
Oh, what a pleasant surprise. It's your parents, darling.
Who left the door unlocked? I haven't even started on the kitchen yet. I'm not even dressed properly. Mother's going to have a field day.
Hello, darling.
Hi, Mum. Excuse the mess.
Only we weren't expecting you so soon.
I have to have an appointment to see my own daughter. Well,
I didn't mean that.
Don't I get a kiss?
Somebody's had fried food for breakfast.
Oh, that was yesterday.
He's pulling your leg, Mum.
I've never understood his particular brand of humour. You look terrible.
Cup of tea?
Now, don't change the subject.
Hello, love. Sorry we're early. I told you you wouldn't be expecting us.
No, you didn't. Anyway, happy Easter. We've brought a few presents.
Oh, you shouldn't have.
Well, I wasn't sure whether I should, but I thought the children would be so hurt. Mind you, Easter's not the same as it was, is it? Do you remember when you were small, you always wore a new dress and your best shoes? It's the same thing every Easter Sunday. You always took such a pride in your appearance in those days.
Yes, Mum.
You look very nice, Elsa.
Will you be getting changed soon?
I'll put the kettle on.
Ah, that's better. Earl Grey or us, Sam, whatever you've got.
Hey, come here, Tiger.
Don't forget your grandma.
Hi, Gran. Happy Easter.
Happy Easter to you, my darling. I've brought you a little present. There you are.
Oh, thanks.
Now, come and sit by me.
Well, I've got some friends over.
Go on, son. Off you go.
Thanks. See you later.
He's looking awfully thin. You aren't feeding him properly, are you, darling? Oh, cute Easter egg, Jamie.
I wouldn't laugh. You're getting one as well.
Oh, when's she going to realise we'd just rather have the dosh?
No Sally and Angus?
No.
So your parents aren't coming, Christopher? Oh, what a pity.
I didn't say that.
They've been delayed, that's all.
Well, it's just as well. We really don't want any more embarrassing scenes, do we?
Elsa.
Hi, everyone.
Oh, well, look who it is. What time do you call this to be coming in?
Oh, better late than never, right, Dad?
Oh, hey, the dirty stop-out is back.
Duncan, darling, where have you been? You look as if you've been dragged through a hedge backwards.
Leave the lad alone, Elsa. What he gets up to is his own business.
Cheers, Grandpa. Is there anything to eat? I am starving.
Here you are. Happy Easter, Duncan.
Oh, Duncan's your favourite.
And one for you, Melanie.
Oh, Duncan's got all the postman pat videos, ain't you, Duncan? But you know what bothers me? If he's only a postman, how comes he's got a private number plate?
You've always been my Duncan's favourite. Isn't that right?
Yeah. Duncan, what's up? What did you do in my gear? Where'd you put it?
Well, I haven't touched it. It's in the shed, where it always is.
Not anymore. I just looked. Please don't tell me it's been nicked.
I knew it. I said this neighbourhood was going downhill. Didn't I, Jack?
We're going to have to call the cops.
You can't.
Why not?
Because we've got it, haven't we, Mel?
Oh, nice one, Claire. Just come right out and tell him, why don't you?
You've got a cheek, Mel.
Well, I thought he wouldn't mind. Sounded rubbish anyway.
All you had to do was ask.
Okay, Roy, can we borrow your disco gear?
No chance. I want it back here by tomorrow. I've got a gig.
We promise, don't we, Mel?
Oh, if you insist.
What's going on?
Nothing. Roy's just remembered where he left his gear. He can be a bit forgetful sometimes, that's all.
Hey, I want a word with you.
Oh, that's a cue for a shop exit.
Well, thanks for your support.
Couldn't you have phoned? Just to let your mother know where you were last night.
Sorry, Dad, but you know how it is.
No, I don't. You really are one selfish... You knew today was important to me. I asked you to be here all day.
So where's Nana and Grandad?
They'll be here soon.
So I'm not the only one who's late, then.
iron a shirt for you, love.
Mum, would you mind if I didn't go to this meal?
Why?
I'm sort of double booked.
Well, why don't you bring her along? We'd love to meet her.
Not yet, eh? It's early days, you know what I mean?
Not really, no. Still, it's your life. But we would like to meet this mystery girl. Shame to bring her home, will you?
Of course not. It's no big mystery. It's not as if it's serious or anything.
Well, you seem to be seeing a lot of this girl, whoever she is. Anyway, the thing is, your dad really wants you all at the meal tonight.
You could have fooled me.
He's worried about your granddad and Nana. We don't know if they're still coming. Please, Duncan.
I'll be there.
Oh, any news?
Not a word. They're still not answering the phone in Newcastle. Obviously, my mother can't bring herself to forgive me.
Oh, come on. Don't give up. They might still turn up. We'll let the Cockerels next door know.
Oh, forget it, Annie. They're not coming. I was stupid to ever think we could patch things up. When everybody's ready, we go to the restaurant and that's the end of it. Okay?
Come and sit next to me, little brother.
Don't. You can't trust her.
I'm sorry we're going to be a few more than we booked. You know what it's like trying to keep everyone happy. In order to get the kids to come, we now have to have all their friends too.
Don't be sorry. It's good for business. Anyway, why change your habits of a lifetime? You feed them all at home usually, don't you? Where are Chris's mum and dad? I thought this was all in their honour.
They were supposed to arrive this afternoon, but we haven't heard from them today. Chris is really worried, not so. I suppose I should get back to him.
Well, look, I'll come and see you both before I go. I'm off out tonight.
Again? I've hardly seen you since you started dating this new man.
Oh, it's not new. It's been 3 months. Anyway. Never miss our girls' nights out.
I should think not.
Should be thinking about settling down, darling.
I've no time for a relationship, Grandma. Not until my career's secure, anyway.
So there's no one at all.
You give yourself too long.
You are 24. Mind you, be careful. Don't go and grab the first person that comes along. Others have made that mistake, I can tell you.
What's everybody have?
Is there a vegetarian menu?
Why do you want to know that?
Because I am a vegetarian.
Since when?
Since Friday.
You went on a school trip to a farm. It's over the page, vegetarian menu.
I'll just have a salad. And a knife and fork. You seem to remember to set the table properly.
They bring the cutlery with the food, Mum.
I didn't think we were going to be joined by every Tom, Dick and Harry. This lot's going to clean me out.
Someone needs you in next weekend.
No, not much. I've got a repointing job. Maybe they'll pay up front.
Yeah, but Nick's finishing that Birmingham job this week. He'll be back with the cash, won't he?
Will he?
He's your partner, for goodness sake. Of course he will.
I haven't heard from him since last Thursday.
Stop worrying. He'll be fine.
I hope so.
Do we have to have that awful music? It's so distracting.
Mum, would you mind if I went back home?
Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
What about your pudding, pet?
Oh, I'm full, thanks, Dad. I'd really like to get these research notes done on time. A couple more hours and I should be done. And then I can relax.
Go on then. We'll save you a minute.
Thanks. I'll see you at home.
Hang on. I'll walk you over. No, you don't. You'll stay here. We all know why you want to go. There you go, Chris. The kids don't want to be stuck with us, right?
Cheers, Grandpa. Come on.
I'll not be offended if anyone wants to split the bill, you know.
Hi.
Wait a back.
Just be careful.
Right. Are we ready for some more wine, yeah?
I thought you'd never ask, Grandpa. It's a nice idea, Mum. We should do it more often.
I'm not so sure about that.
We could come back on Wednesday for your wedding anniversary.
Well, you've remembered. One doesn't ever see it.
Has it been a good evening?
Very enjoyable, thank you, Maria.
Good. We aim to please.
Love the music.
Oh, I love all the old musicals. Showboat, A Star Is Born, Carousel.
I didn't have you down for a musicals fan. You're far too young.
Oh, I saw Singing in the Rain years ago and I was hooked.
That's one of my favourites. Listen to me wittering on.
Look, it's okay. I've got to make a move. I'll have the wine brought over to you, Jack.
So we're not going to have the pleasure of your company, then?
No. Meeting someone.
Really? Well, enjoy yourself. See you again soon, I hope.
Hello?
I think people are so rude leaving their mobile phone switched on in restaurants, don't you, Gran?
Absolutely.
Melanie or Claire, something for you.
Oh, hi, it's Claire. Hi.
Sorry, I hope you don't mind. We just gave your number to a few people.
Yeah, what people?
Just friends. Keep your hair on. Yeah, right. No, thanks. Let me know. Yeah. Bye.
Is everything all right?
Not really. Something's come up. I've got to get back.
Oh.
Do you think come with me, Melanie?
What, now?
Now. I'm really sorry about this, Mrs. Hart, and thanks for the meal, Mr. Hart. It was lovely.
Anything we can do?
No. I mean, no, thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
What was all that about?
Men.
Okay. Yeah, 5 minutes. Yes. Yes, I promise. Bye.
I take it that was lovely, boy.
Yep, I've got to go. See you.
But hang on. When am I going to meet him? I'm your best friend. I'm supposed to vet him.
Well, I vetted him. He comes up to scratch.
So what's wrong with him? Is he ugly? He is, isn't he? He's big ugly. Call me.
So sorry that Angus and Sally couldn't make it.
Yeah, so am I.
They didn't want to come. They should have...